Now let's see about basics of XML. So now we are going to discuss about what is XML. Next one, what are the uses of XML? Next one, what is XHTML? Next one, what are the major differences between HTML and XML? Differences between HTML and XML. Next one, XML syntax rules. Next one, XML elements. Next one, XML attributes. XML attributes, and the next one is XML comments. Next one, entity references. Entity references. So in this class we are going to discuss about all these basic topics. So what is XML, uses of XML, what is XHTML, and what are the major differences between HTML and XML. Next one, XML syntax rules. Next one, XML elements, XML attributes, XML comments, and the last one is XML entity references. So now let's see the first one. What is XML? XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. Markup Language. So from extensible, X is taken. From markup, M is taken. From language, L is taken. So it also contains, it is also a markup language. So markup language means it contains a collection of markup tags. Okay. Let's see what is the major advantage of XML. Here the major advantage of XML is by using XML we can describe the structure of an XML document. We can describe structure of a document. So in order to describe structure of a document we uses XML. So that means by using XML we can describe data. So here the major focus is what is the data? So the major focus will be on the corresponding data. Whereas by using HTML we can display a web page. So in order to display the content on the web page we uses HTML, hypertext markup language. Whereas XML for describing the structure of a document. Here the structure of a document is nothing but the major focus will be on data. XML is also a W3C technology. So W3C stands for World Wide Web Consortium. Okay. Here we have various W3C technologies like HTML, CSS, JavaScript, Servlet, JSP. All these are nothing but some .NET, ASP.NET. All these are nothing but various technologies, various W3C technologies. So all the web related technologies are available in W3C. Okay. So XML is also a W3C technology. So this is about what is XML. So what is XML? XML stands for Extensible Markup Language. And by using XML, mainly we can describe the structure of an XML document. Now let's see the uses of XML. Uses of XML. Uses of XML. So let's see what are the uses of XML. By using XML, we can store the data. So XML is mainly useful in order to store the data. And it is also useful in order to share the data. It is also useful in order to transfer the data from one application to another application. And the next one is it is also useful in order to exchange data between different applications. It is also useful in order to create a new languages. So by using XML, new languages will be created. So in order to create the new languages, we use XML. And here we have various languages like WSDL. WSDL stands for Web Services Description Language. Web Services Description Language. Next, RSS. RSS stands for Really Simple Syndication. Next one, RDF. RDF stands for Resource Data Framework. Resource Data Framework. So all these three languages are developed with the help of XML only. So WSDL, Web Services Description Language, Really Simple Syndication, Resource Data Framework. So all these languages are developed with the help of XML only. Here the data is nothing but, let us assume that we have an element called name. So this is nothing but starting element. This is nothing but ending element. So between those elements we place some data. So let the data here is Ramu. So by using XML mainly, we can store the data. So this is nothing but data here. So in order to store the data of the document, we use XML. As well as we can share the data. As well as we can transfer the data from one application to another application. Next, we can exchange the data between different applications. Next, we can create new languages. So several languages are already created with the help of XML. Now let's see the next one. So what is the next one? XHTML. XHTML stands for Extensible Hypertext Markup Language. XHTML stands for Extensible HTML. So we know what is HTML. Hypertext Markup Language. If HTML document follows the syntax rules of XML, then it is called as XHTML. So by using XHTML, we can design the web pages just like HTML. But XHTML means the corresponding HTML document should follows the syntax rules of XML. Now let's see in the next topic only, we will see what are the various XML syntax rules. So that is about what is XHTML. Now let's see the differences between HTML and XML. So what are the various differences between HTML and XML. HTML is mainly useful in order to display the web pages. So in order to display web pages, we use HTML. So if we want to display some content on the web page, then we use HTML. Whereas XML is mainly useful in order to describe the structure of the document. So in order to describe the structure of the document, XML is mainly used. So here the major focus will be on data, storing the data, sharing the data, transferring the data, exchanging the data. So the major focus will be on the data. Here the second difference is HTML is not a case sensitive language. That means HTML is case insensitive language, whereas XML is case sensitive language. So what is case sensitive language? Lowercase and uppercase variables are different. Okay, just like C, C++, Java, C sharp, XML is also case sensitive language. Whereas HTML is not a case sensitive language. So not a case sensitive means there is no difference between lowercase and uppercase. So we can use only lowercase or only uppercase or combinations of both. There is no problem here. And the next difference is HTML tags are predefined. So all the HTML tags are predefined only. So we can't use our own tags. Whereas XML tags are user defined. XML tags are user defined. So we can create
our bone tacks with the help of the XML. So these three are the major differences between HTML and XML. Now let's see the next topic in XML. Basics of XML. So what is the next topic? XML syntax rules. XML syntax rules. So while creating any XML document, we have to follow some syntaxes. So now we are going to discuss those syntaxes. So here the first syntax rule is an XML document must contain only one root element. An XML document must contain only one root element. So we have to place all the elements inside the root element. That is the first syntax rule. And the second syntax rule is, if it is a container element. So container element means we have start tag, next end tag. So it starts with forward slash end tag. So between start tag and end tag, we have some content. So if it is a container element, then for every starting tag, we can have the corresponding end tag. So here, what is the second rule? Start tag should have corresponding end tag. Corresponding end tag. And the next rule is an empty element must ends with forward slash symbol. Empty element means we have only start tag. Let here the element is image. So we can have only start tag ends with forward slash. So empty element must ends with forward slash. So this is the rule which we have to follow. And the next rule is XML attribute values must be enclosed in double quotations. So XML attribute values must be enclosed in double quotations. Let we have some attribute here. img image src is equal to, here image is nothing but element, src is nothing but attribute. Within the double quotations we have to provide the value. So what is the next rule here? Attribute values must be enclosed in double quotations. And the next rule is XML tag elements are properly nested. So we know what is nested. Okay, so placing one tag inside another tag is known as nesting. Okay, so what is the next rule here? XML elements are properly nested. So let the first tag here is A, next tag is B, next tag is so C. So what is the last opening tag? C. So first we have to close this tag. Next opening tag B. So next we have to close this tag. Next opening tag A. So next we have to close this tag. Okay, so the tags are closed in the reverse order of their creation. So this is the fifth rule here. The tag elements are properly nested. And the next rule is XML is case sensitive language. XML is case sensitive language. So that means there is a difference between lowercase element and uppercase element. So we have to follow all these rules while creating an XML document. Here, what are XML elements? All XML elements are user defined elements only. So there are no predefined elements. So all the elements are user defined elements only. Now let's see XML elements. So we know that every XML document contains a collection of XML elements. XML elements. So here we have two types of elements. What is the first one? Container element. Second one, empty element. So if it is a container element, then we have start tag, end tag. So between start and end tag, we have some content. So for every start tag, we must have the corresponding end tag. So here, what is end tag here? Less than slash, start is nothing but end tag here. Okay. So the name of the tag is same here. And what is the next one? If it is an empty tag, then it must ends with forward slash. If it is an empty tag, then it must ends with forward slash. So these are the mainly used tags here, mainly used elements here, whether container elements or user defined elements. Container elements or empty elements. Here for XML elements, we have to follow the rules of the identifier.
Why? Because here XML elements are nothing but user defined elements. There are no predefined XML elements. So in order to create an XML element, we have to follow the rules of identifier.
So an XML element is a combination of alphabets, such as lowercase alphabets, uppercase alphabets, and digits. And it accepts only one symbol, that is underscore symbol. So remaining symbols are not allowed. And the second rule is an XML element must start with either alphabet or underscore.
An XML element must start with either alphabet or underscore. That means an XML element cannot start with a digit.
And the next rule here is, so an XML element can't start with digit.
So XML element can't start with digit.
It may start with either with alphabet or underscore. That is the third rule here. And the fourth rule is, what is the third rule here? Cannot start with digit. Cannot start with digit. And the next rule is, blank spaces are not allowed. Blank spaces are not allowed in XML element. Not allowed. And the last rule is,
XML element cannot start with
either lowercase XML or uppercase XML.
An XML element cannot start with either lowercase XML or uppercase XML. And all the XML elements are what? User defined elements. So that's why we are following all these rules in order to create an XML element. So let us take an element. So less than ABC. So is it a valid XML element? Yes. Why? Because it contains alphabets.
ABC one,
it is also valid one because it contains alphabets as well as digit.
1ABC,
it is not valid XML document. It is not valid XML element.
Why? Because XML element cannot start with a digit. Next, XML ABC,
it is also not a valid XML element. Why? Because XML element cannot start with XML. Okay. So this is about XML elements.
So now let's see the next one. So what is the next one? XML attributes. So we know what is the use of attributes. Attributes are mainly useful in order to provide the additional information about the element. So in order to provide the additional information about the element,
we use attribute.
So here person is nothing but element. Gender is nothing but attribute. Female is nothing but attribute value. So what is person? Element. Gender, attribute. Is equal to, within the double quotation, female is nothing but attribute value. So we have to enclose attribute value within the double quotations. So we must place attribute values within the double quotations. So this is about XML attributes. Now let's see the next one. The next one is XML comments. Here XML comments are similar to HTML comments. Any XML comment starts with less than, not, minus minus, and ends with minus minus, greater than. So any XML comment starts with less than, not, minus minus, exclamation mark, less than, not, minus minus, and here we have to write the comment minus minus, greater than. If it is a multi-line comment, then we have to write like this. So less than, exclamation mark, minus minus, minus minus. Next, each line starts with minus minus, minus minus, minus minus, minus minus, minus minus. Let it is the last line. So minus minus, letter there. So this is nothing but a multi-line comment. So it starts with less than, not, minus minus minus, minus minus. Each line starts with minus minus, minus minus, minus minus, minus minus. Let it be the last line. So minus minus, letter there. So this is nothing but multi-line comment. This is nothing but single line comment. Here we places some text here. So what is the use of the comments? Comments are not executed by the XML parser. Okay. Only for our understanding purpose, we use as comments. XML comments are similar to HTML comments. Hypertext markup language comments. HTML comments. Both are same only. Whereas for CSS comments, we have to follow the rules of C language or C++ or Java. A CSS comment starts with slash star and ends with star red slash. So CSS comment starts with slash star and ends with star slash.
Whereas HTML comment less than not minus minus, minus minus greater than. HTML and XML comments are same. Whereas CSS comments are similar to C, C++, Java. And what is the last one? XML entity references. Entity references. Let us assume that we want to use less than symbol. We want to display some less than symbol. If we try to display less than, then what will happen is XML parser, because here we use just XML parser. Every browser contains XML parser. It is the duty of XML parser to execute our XML document. So XML document is executed by XML parser. Okay. If we want to display less than, then we use just less than symbol. But it is treated as left angular bracket. If we want to display greater than symbol, then it is not possible to display greater than, because it is treated as right angular bracket. So in order to overcome that problem, we use entity references. Any entity reference starts with ampersand and ends with semicolon. This is nothing but that entity reference name. If we want to display less than, then the entity reference is starts with ampersand, LT, semicolon. Next, if you want to display greater than, then the entity reference is ampersand, GT, semicolon. GT stands for greater than. Next, if you want to display ampersand symbol, then it starts with ampersand, AMP, semicolon. Any entity reference starts with ampersand, entity name ends with semicolon. Next one, if you want to display apostrophe means single quotation, then ampersand, APOS, semicolon. If you want to display double quotations, then ampersand, QUOT, semicolon. If you want to display some fraction part like this, generally a fraction will be printed like this, but I want to print like this, 1 by 4. Then we use just ampersand, frac, 1 4. Okay. So what is the output? 1 by 4. Like this the output will be printed. It won't print like this. Ampersand, frac, 1 4. So if you want to display 1 by 2, then 1 2. If you want to display some copyright symbol, then we use just ampersand, copy, semicolon. Next, if you want to display some capital J, then we use just like this ampersand, hash, 65. Here 65 is nothing but the ASCII value of capital J. So capital J will be printed like this. If you want to display 97, if you want to display small A, then we use just like this ampersand, hash, 97. So 97 is nothing but the ASCII value of small A. So likewise, we can use just various entity references. And now let's see a simple XML document. Here the extension for an XML document is .xml. So let name of the XML document is note.xml. So this note is nothing but root element. So root element will be given as name of the file. Any XML document starts with XML declaration. So less than question mark, XML version is equal to within the double quotations 1.0 question mark greater than. So this statement is known as XML declaration or processing instruction. XML declaration or processing instruction. So XML declaration specifies that it is an XML document. So XML declaration is not compulsory, it is optional. So XML declaration starts with less than question mark, XML in lowercase letters, space, we are using 1.0 version. So version is attribute is equal to within the double quotations 1.0. 1.0 is nothing but that attribute value. So XML is element, version is attribute, 1.0 is nothing but attribute value. Next to question mark greater than. So it specifies that it is an XML document. So this document is executed by XML parser. So by default, XML parser is available in every browser. Now, what is the root of this XML document? Note. So this one is nothing but root of the XML document. So for each starting element, we must have corresponding ending element. So less than slash note. Here, let us declare four elements. The first element is from. Let us write some name here, Ramu. Next to close the from tag. Next to 2. Let 2 here is Krishna. Next to close 2 tag.
Next, let us define one more tag, heading, some reminder, next close heading tag. Next one is body, don't forget. Here we want to use, we want to display like this, but if you want to display single quotation, it is better to use entity reference. So ampersand APOS semicolon apostrophe, the single quotation will be printed. Don't forget to meet tomorrow. To meet tomorrow. Next close body tag. So node is nothing but root element. So this root element totally contains four child elements. So from corresponding end tag, to corresponding end tag, heading corresponding end tag, body corresponding end tag. Here we want to display a single quotation apostrophe here. In order to display that single quotation, we have character entity differences. Then this document is following XML syntax rules. So what will happen is this document will be printed as the output. If there are any syntax mistakes, like we don't have ending tag here, then XML parser will display the error. There is no end tag for this from. So likewise, the error will be displayed. If this document is following the syntax rules of XML, then the proper output will be displayed. Okay. So this is about XML document. So this is about, here we have one more topic. There are two types of XML document. There are two types of XML document. The first document is well-formed XML document. The first one is well-formed XML document. And the second one is valid XML document. First one, well-formed XML document. Second one, valid XML document. If an XML document follows XML syntax rules, then it is known as well-formed XML document. So what are the XML syntax rules? XML document should contain one root element. Every start tag must have corresponding end tag. Next, end tag must end with forward slash symbol. Next, attribute values must be enclosed in double quotations. Next one, what is the next one? We have attribute values must be enclosed in double quotations. Next, the tag elements are properly nested. Next, XML is case sensitive language. So if you follow that rules, then it is called as well-formed XML document. So what is well-formed XML document? An XML document is said to be well-formed if it follows the syntax rules of XML. And the next one is valid XML document. An XML document is said to be valid if it is well-formed document. That means it has to follow the syntax rules of XML, as well as if it follows the syntax rules of DTD and XML. DTD and XML schema. DTD stands for document type definition. So an XML document is said to be valid if it follows the syntax rules of XML, as well as if it follows the syntax rules of DTD and XML schema, then it is called as valid XML document. So a valid XML document is nothing but it should be a well-formed XML document, as well as it should be validated against with DTD or XML schema. So DTD stands for document type definition. So this is about the basics of XML.